And it's hard to believe, but the kickoff to the biggest show in town is tomorrow.
From the air show to the fireworks, those behind Thunder over Louisville are ready to show off a year's worth of work.
And if you're planning to watch Thunder from the water, the Coast Guard is urging boaters to use extra caution.
Eric King is live on the 24th floor of the Galt House with a behind-the-scenes look at what everyone can expect. Good morning to you, Eric.
Good morning to you. Yeah, we didn't talk a lot about boat safety last year because, if you remember, this, we were pretty much underwater and there was not a lot of people who were even allowed on the river. The Coast Guard was in charge of that, saying stay away. And for the, I guess it was a good thing because most people did. I want to introduce you to Ron Easley, of course, Lieutenant Ron Easley with the Coast Guard. So let's start with last year. People did pay attention to that warning of staying off the river.
Absolutely. Last year we were hoping, based on the conditions, that most boaters would just watch shoreside. This year, we're anticipating that there's going to be hundreds of boaters, or up to, you know, there's potential for hundreds of boaters. So we just want to get the message out for safe boating, just to make sure that everyone who is going to be on the water pre-checks all their equipment, check your navigation lights if you're going to be out during nighttime, during the fireworks, make sure that they're working out, everything's working properly. Mm-hmm. Check your radio, that it's working properly. Make sure you have the proper size anchor for your vessel. And just be aware of your surroundings. There's potential to have a lot of boats around you, and just be safe.
This is a celebratory type of event. So with that, and a lot of assets, comes alcohol. What are the logistics when it comes to that on the boats, and what would you guys be looking for?
The Coast Guard is going to be working along with local law enforcement to enforce BUI, or boating under influence. And the best thing to do is just don't mix the two.
And lastly, as far as logistics on where boats can be, I know there was some talk about the Big Four Bridge, which I believe is a pedestrian bridge. Is that where boats need to be up from there?
Correct. The restricted area is going to be about a couple hundred yards upbound of the Big Four pedestrian bridge, the railroad bridge, all the way through McAlpin Lock. That'll be from just prior to the air show through the event, through the fireworks.
All right. If you're going to be among the lucky and you're going to be on a boat, you know exactly what to do now. With that, guys, back to you.
All right, Eric. Thank you very much.